Hello and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to see how to create three easy action graphics: a circle burst, a star burst, and a line asset. Let's get into the topic. Select the ellipse tool and set the fill to none and the stroke to solid color. Set the stroke width to whatever you like. I am setting it to 15. With holding shift key, I am using the ellipse tool to create a perfect circle. Centerline the circle. Press S to bring up the scale property. And at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for scale with 0%. Go to the 1 second mark and change the scale value to 100%. Now open up the shape one layer, open up the contents, then the ellipse one, and then the stroke one. In that, create a keyframe for stroke width at the start of the timeline and change the value to around 75. Go to the 1 second mark and change the value to 0. Press U to bring up all the keyframes. Select all the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Ramp preview this. Yeah, that's it. If you feel the animation is taking too long, reduce the distance between the keyframes and you'll have something like this. Yeah. Also, you can duplicate the shape layer and offset it to around 4 or 5 frames and you'll get a animation like this. Double circle burst. Let's move on to the next one. The line assets. Grab the pen tool and set the fill to none. Set the stroke to solid color and create a line like this. Open up the shape one layer and add trim paths. Open up the trim paths and at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for start and end values with 0%. Go to the 10 frame mark and change the start value to 100%. And go forward about another 10 frames, that's 20 frame mark, and set the end value to 100%. Ramp preview this. Yeah, good. Select all the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Feel free to change the keyframes as per your need of speed. Duplicate the shape one layer twice and offset it randomly. And also change the positions to wherever you want. I am displacing the position to vertical values. And bam, you have this nice looking line asset. Let's get into the last one, the starburst. Grab the pen tool and set the fill to none and the stroke to solid color. Create a stroke like this. Open up the shape one layer and add repeater. Go to the repeater one and set the copies to 6. Open up the repeater transform and change the position value to 0. Set the rotation to 60 degrees. Now also change the anchor point as shown to have a proper center for the starburst. VAT trim paths to the stroke layer. And at the start of the timeline, create keyframe for start and end values and change the end value to 0. Go to the 10 frame mark and set the start value to 100%. Go to the 20 frame mark and set the end value to 100%. Select all the keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now ramp preview this. Yeah, that's good. Also, if you want, you can duplicate the shape layers and manipulate whatever you want. I am duplicating the shape 1 layer and scaling it down to around 80%. And also, I am offsetting it to around 5 frames. Since we have changed the anchor points, the position of the duplicated layer changes, so we have to fix that. So open up the position property and change the position to make it to the center of the starburst. Now ramp preview this, yeah, that's super. That's it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Check out my Instagram page, you will feel amazed. Make sure you click on the follow button there. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share. And thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. This is Raudan signing off.